One sparkly day, in the middle of a cold spell, Rhubarb went out into the garden and noticed right away that his mouth was on fire. Rhubarb thought of nothing except the fact that he was the luckiest dog he knew, and that if the door had accidentally splonked closed, he'd be smoking all over by now. Much later on, with all his courage piled up inside his ears, Rhubarb peeped his nose out. "Puff!" uttered Rhubarb. "Puff!" spluttered he, as he huffed and puffed great big lungfuls of smoky blue out into the frosty morning. "It must be that coal I ate yesterday." Quite pleased now with his smoking mouth, Rhubarb ran down to the pond. Then, stopping in his tracks, he almost fell over with amazement at the sight before his very eyes. "First my smoking mouth, and now this," muttered Rhubarb. "Well, I never! A duck, with legs and feet," he said, with a nip in the air. "What a delightful duck," mused Rhubarb, "and what pretty legs." And he dived his nose towards the water and crashed it into the ice with a thud that could be heard all over the garden. As angry as an alligator, Rhubarb demanded to know who had double-glazed the pond in the night. And as he jumped up and down, he slipped and went spinning towards the centre of the pond. "What fun!" grinned Rhubarb. "What jolly, jolly fun!" he squealed. "What new wonderments have you invented in your wisdom? What new games have you given to the world?" Rhubarb rumbled on as he tied a couple of bones to his athlete's feet and announced to the world he'd invented golf. "Good heavens, I think I've invented it too slippery," gulped Rhubarb. Gaining confidence and humming the Scraper's Waltz, Rhubarb was as happy as the day. And he noticed that all the birds were squeaking the Scraper's Waltz. And Cowardy Custard, the big fat cat, was screeching the Scraper's Waltz. And all in all, the whole thing sounded beautiful. As Rhubarb whirled into a frenzied fantasia, he had indeed invented golf. As the sun rose warmly into the morning sky, Rhubarb golfed on, and the garden orchestra hummed and buzzed its way to the finale as Rhubarb spun round faster and faster. The sun smiled, the icicles melted, and the double glazing creaked. Crunch went the double glazing, and plodonk went Rhubarb as he splashed into the water. Custard broke the fence into pieces with an uncontrollable giggle, and the birds up the tree went wild with laughter, and Rhubarb was wet. As Rhubarb shook himself and scuttled up to the house, he barked with fury at the garden animals and promised them that one day he would invent ice skating.